Welcome back to your free Windows 7 training course. In this video, I will look at BranchCache. It is not uncommon for companies to have branch offices connected to a central office. Internet speed and connections are getting better, but sometimes you may find the link between the head office and a branch office to be quite slow and may even be unreliable. This especially may be the case when you are dealing with links that travel halfway across the world. BranchCache works by caching files on the local network after they have been copied over the wide area network. If another computer requests a file that has been cached, the file is copied over the local area network rather than the wide area network. This helps reduce the amount of traffic traveling over your wide area networks. In order to start using BranchCache, you require Windows 7 Enterprise or Ultimate Edition and also Windows Server 2008 R2. Once you have configured BranchCache to operate, it will automatically, by default, kick in when the round-trip latency from your client to server exceeds 80 milliseconds. If you have a high-speed link that has low latency, BranchCache, even when configured correctly, may never operate. To change this, you need to change the default latency. BranchCache can operate in two different modes. The first mode is hosted mode. Hosted mode requires Windows Server 2008 R2 at each branch location. The data, when transferred across the network, is encrypted with SSL encryption, so the server also requires an SSL certificate. The advantage of hosted mode is that BranchCache is always available, assuming the server is always on. The way hosted mode works is like this. When a client attempts to access a file across the wide area network, the round trip is calculated. If it is greater than the default 80 milliseconds, that is, the time taken from the client computer to the WAN to the server and back again, the file is automatically cached with BranchCache. If another computer on the local network now attempts to access the same file across the wide area network, the client can instead access the file from the cache on the local server. When the file request comes through, the server will first check over the WAN link to see if the file has changed since it cached it, and if not, will transfer the file to the client from its cache. This saves the file having to be copied over the WAN link a second time. If you don't have Windows Server 2008 R2 at each branch office, you may use the second mode called Distributed Cache Mode. In this mode, each Windows 7 computer has its own cache. When a file is copied over the network, it is stored on the local cache. If another Windows 7 computer wants the file, it will send a broadcast on the network, asking the other computers if one of them has it. If one of the computers does, the file will be transferred from that computer rather than using the wide area network. In order to start using BranchCache, it needs to be set up. This can be done through group policy or using Netsh. If you use group policy, the settings are found in Computer Configuration, Administrative Templates, Network, and then BranchCache. There are 5 settings for BranchCache found in group policy. The first, Turn On BranchCache, when enabled simply turns on BranchCache. If you do not configure this setting, BranchCache will not operate regardless of what you set the other settings to. The next setting, Set BranchCache Distributed Cache Mode, configures BranchCache to run in distributed mode. If you want to run BranchCache in distributed mode, you simply need to enable this setting. The next setting, Set BranchCache Hosted Cache Mode, configures BranchCache to run in hosted mode. Once you enable this setting, you need to also configure which server BranchCache will contact to download data. The next setting, Configure BranchCache for Network Files, determines the latency time that will be used with BranchCache. The default is 80. Remember, this setting is the round trip value. That is the time taken from the client computer across the WAN and back again. If you want to enable BranchCache to always operate, set this value to 0. If you want to stop BranchCache from operating, then set the value really high. The last setting, set percentage of disk space used for client computer cache, is the percentage of hard disk space that BranchCache will use to store files. The default is 5%. This is worked out from the total hard disk space, not the available free space. In a large enterprise environment, you are most likely going to use group policy to configure BranchCache. However, there is also a number of netsh commands that you can use to configure BranchCache. The first command I want to look at is the netsh BranchCache show status command. When this command is run from a command prompt, this will show the current status of the service that runs BranchCache and the service mode BranchCache is running in. Service mode being whether BranchCache is in hosted mode or distributed mode. BranchCache is currently not configured. If I want to configure BranchCache to run in hosted mode, I would run the command BranchCache set service mode equals hosted client. Following this, I need to enter in the server by typing location equals, the BranchCache server in this case is fs1.training.local. Notice when this command is run, it also starts the BranchCache service and configures the firewall. This means you could configure your Windows 7 client to start using BranchCache with one command. If you want to configure BranchCache to run in distributed mode, it is simply a matter of running the same command again, but this time change the mode to distributed. Notice that this time I do not need to add the location parameter because distributed mode does not use a server. The next command sets the cache size that will be used with BranchCache. The amount is in bytes, so this example sets the cache to 20 megabytes. You can also set the size based on the disk size. To do this, use the size parameter followed by percent equals true. Once you configure BranchCache, you will probably want to get some statistics to see if it is working. To do this, run the command show local cache. This will also show you how the cache is configured, where it is stored, and how much cache is currently in use. If you find that the cache never seems to get used, you may need to reduce the latency value that BranchCache is working on. If you set the value to 0, BranchCache will cache all files. If you simply want to confirm it is working, set the value to 0. Later on, you can increase the value. If you use netsh, you will not need to configure the firewall. If, however, you use group policy, you will need to configure the firewall either manually or through group policy. BranchCache needs certain ports open, which can change depending on which mode it is running in. The first port that needs to be open is port 80 for inbound and outbound traffic. This is regardless of which mode you use. If you decide to use distributed mode, you require UDP port 3702 open for inbound and outbound traffic. If you decide to use hosted mode, you only require TCP port 43 for outbound traffic. When used correctly, BranchCache should help to take some load off of your wide area networks, which should hopefully give your end users a better experience. In the next video, I will look at BitLocker. BitLocker is a system in Windows 7 that allows you to encrypt your hard disk, protecting it from theft. For the rest of this free training course on Windows 7, please check out our webpage or YouTube channel. Thanks again for watching.